So today I am going to discuss the different echocardiographic view, and as we know, the 2D echo windows are basically four different windows we can get. The most one important one are parasternal view, which can be of long axis or the short axis view, the apical view, which can be of again 4-chamber, 5-chamber or 2-chamber view, the subcostal view, and the last one is the suprasternal view. So the first and the most important view is the left parasternal view, which can be again of long axis view or the short axis view. So for parasternal window, the patient can be in the supine position or the patient can be in the left lateral position. So most of the views are being obtained when the patient is in the left lateral position with the right hand straight and the leg slightly flexed. And the parasternal window, is the advantage is that it can also be taken when the patient is on ventilator and the patient is in supine position. So these are the surface marking or the landmarks of the left parasternal window. We can see in this picture, basically this is the surface marking of the heart, and we can see the parasternal window is occupies a very small portion of the heart in the anterior border. So if we see in the three-dimensional image, we can easily see that how the echo probe is being put on the left parasternal area, and we can see from this picture that the echo probe cuts the heart at a particular angle and it mainly goes to the right left ventricle and sometimes to the part of the right ventricle and the great vessels of the heart. So this is the 3D image where the pointer is being pointed towards the right shoulder of the patient, and it's basically parallel to a line joining the right shoulder and the left groin of the patient. So this is the one of the landmarks where the probe can be put in the mostly in the second or third intercostal space, and sometimes in the fourth intercostal space also to get a better window. And mostly the transducer is in the left sternal edge, and the pointer, we can see it is directed towards the right shoulder, and basically it lies in a straight line which joins the right shoulder to the left side of the groin or the iliac crest. And the most important point is the probe should be pointed along the long axis, okay, from the right shoulder to the cardiac apex. And if you see, basically this is the parasternal long axis view, we can see the echo or the echo images, basically the ultrasound image, ultrasound beam, it passes through the mostly through the left ventricle and to some of the parts of the great vessels and to the what is called as the right ventricle, part of the right ventricle. So this is the long axis, and at a perpendicular to that we will get the short axis view, which will be discussed later on these videos. So if you see in the cross section, so this is the parasternal long axis view, we can clearly see how the echo beam passes through the left ventricle, and basically from anterior to posterior the different chambers which are visualized. First is the right ventricular free wall, second is the right ventricular cavity, the interventricular septum, this is the left ventricle, the or cavity of the left ventricle, these are the papillary muscles, these are the chorda tendini, and this is the mitral valve, this is the aortic valve, these are the ascending aorta, and this is the left atrium, and sometimes we may see a descending aorta also. Okay, so this is the posterior wall of the left ventricle, and this is the basically the pericardium. Sometimes we can see the pericardial fluids if there is a pericardial effusion in the anterior to the right ventricle and the left ventricle. Okay, now we'll go to the individual component and we'll see how the views look like. So this is basically the general view of the heart, and the left parasternal long axis view or the plaques view, we can see the RVOT, the interventricular septum, the LVOT, the anterior mitral leaflet, the posterior mitral leaflet, the left atrium, and we can see only the two cusp of the coronary or the aortic cusp. One is the right coronary cusp and second is the non-coronary cusp. Okay, this is the wall of the different chambers. This is the free wall of the right ventricle, this is the free wall of the left ventricle. Okay, and we can see this is the left atrium. Okay, and this is the left ventricular inferolateral wall, and this is the left ventricular anterior superior wall, and this is the small coronary sinus. So now coming to the valve, the different valve, the most important valve is the what is called as the aortic valve. We can see beautiful the aortic valve. These are the two cusps of the aortic valve leaflet. This is the aortic valve right coronary cusp, and this is the non coronary cusp, because basically the left coronary cusp is not easily visualized, and we can see the clear cut opposition of the both the valves to each other. And this is the size of the, you can say, the aortic root. Similarly, if you see the mitral valve, you can see beautifully the mitral valve. This is the two leaflets. One is called the mitral valve anterior leaflets, and this is called the mitral valve posterior leaflet. Okay. Now, the most important point here is we can also get what is called as the tricuspid valve, but it is basically obtained in a specialized view. So when we just on the left parasternal long axis view, we can slightly rotate the transducer at in an angular plane and just depress the probe towards the cephaloid end. We can beautifully get what is called the plaques RV view. So the plaques view can be again divided into two types. One is called the plaques LV view, and the second is called the plaques RV view. So plaques LV view is basically to visualize the left ventricle, whereas the plaques RV view is basically to visualize the right ventricle and the tricuspid valve. But the most important point here is you have to be expertise in obtaining the plaques RV view, because most of the cases or most of the scenarios, this is a very difficult view to obtain.